Hi, I'm John Dosh, Emergency Manager for Escambia County. Hurricane season runs from June 1st to November 30th. Every coastal community along the Atlantic Gulf Coast, including Escambia County, is vulnerable to these massive storms. Hurricane hazards include high winds, heavy rains, storm surge, inland flooding, and tornadoes. Recent storms such as Sandy, Irene, and Ike have given the rest of the nation a better understanding of the threats posed to our area. You may have heard about different national forecasts predict the number of named storms for this hurricane season. Please don't use that information to impact how you prepare. And as Escambia County knows, it only takes one storm to devastate our community. Forecasts at the National Hurricane Center and your Escambia County Emergency Management team are constantly keeping an eye on the tropics, all part of an effort to make sure you have as much time as possible to prepare for storm's landfall. But you need to do your part before the storm sets its sights on Escambia County. You can do it by going to BeReadyEscambia.com. Storm surge is the deadliest hazard associated with hurricanes. It's a rise in seawater produced by water being pushed toward the shore by the force of winds. But storm surge is not just a coastal event. In some areas, seawater can travel well inland with devastating consequences. Storm surge is strongly influenced by the hurricane's track, forward motion, intensity, and size. Changes in any one of those storm characteristics will significantly alter the storm's impact. More information can be provided on BeReadyEscambia.com on hurricanes and storm surge. Hurricane force winds range from 74 to more than 180 miles per hour. The Saffir-Simpson Hurricane Wind Scale rates winds on a scale from 1 to 5 based on the storm's strongest winds and it related to the wind speed to potential impact and damages. Tropical storms have lower wind speeds, anywhere between 39 and 73 miles per hour, but tropical storm force winds are strong enough to be dangerous as well. In fact, Escambia County Emergency Management plans to treat these storms in many of the same ways we respond to hurricanes. Hurricanes and tropical storms can also produce tornadoes that add to the storm's destructive power. They are the most likely to occur in the right front quadrant of a tropical cyclone, but they can also be embedded in the rain bands well away from the storm's center. As the storm approaches, the National Weather Service is responsible for issuing watches and warnings for tornadoes, inland high winds, and flooding. Make sure you have a battery-powered weather radio and backup batteries so you can always be informed. When it comes to hurricanes, wind speeds don't tell the whole story. Hurricanes produce storm surge, tornadoes, and oftentimes, the most deadly of all, inland flooding. Inland flooding can be a major threat to communities, including Escambia County, because tropical storms and hurricanes can dump significant amounts of rain onto one community. Nationwide, a quarter of the hurricane fatalities during the past 50 years are a direct result of inland flooding. The intense rainfall is not directly related to the wind speed of these storms. In fact, some of the worst flood events have occurred from weaker storms that drift slowly or stall over our area. For example, 2001 Tropical Storm Allison produced heavy rainfall and catastrophic flooding in Houston, Texas area. 41 people were killed. The Federal Emergency Management Agency estimated the Tropical Storm Allison caused more than $5 billion worth of damage. Most of that happened in the Houston metro area. So the next time you hear a hurricane or a tropical storm, also think about the threat of flooding. Get flood insurance. Flood damage is not usually covered by homeowners insurance. The National Flood Insurance Program provides federally backed flood insurance for residents and business owners. Surviving a hurricane all comes down to planning well before the storm arrives. Please take the time to have a hurricane plan in place. To learn more about hurricane plans, please visit BeReadyEscambia.com. You should know the types of hazards that could affect your family and know your home's vulnerability to storm surge, flooding, and winds. When you are at BeReadyEscambia.com, look up which evacuation zone your home is in. Then plan an evacuation route. Assemble a disaster supply kit and have enough water, non-perishable foods, and medication for the first 72 hours after a storm makes landfall. The first 72 are on you. When a hurricane watch is issued, the onset of tropical storm force winds is possible within 48 hours. Once the watch is issued, double-check your disaster supply kit to make sure you have all the needed supplies. Activate your hurricane plan. If you own a boat, you may need to make time to secure it. A hurricane warning means tropical storm force winds are expected within 36 hours. Be prepared to use your disaster supply kit and take it with you if ordered to evacuate. Secure your home as best as you can and remain in a safe place through the storm. When the storm is over, please don't be a sightseer. If you do venture outdoors, look out for flooded roads and fallen power lines. Please be prepared. Visit BeReadyEscambia.com for all your storm preparedness needs. As we've seen in the past, preparedness can save lives.